We're deriving elementary formulas for doing numerical integration or quadrature. We derived the midpoint rule. The next one up is the trapezoidal rule. The trapezoidal rule uses the value of the function at the two endpoints of the interval by basically approximating the integral by a trapezoid. So let's see how to derive that. Remember, we're deriving elementary formulas. So I sub h is the integral from 0 to h of f of x dx. We derive the midpoint rule by doing a Taylor series expansion of f of x about the point x equals h over 2. Here I have the first five terms in the expansion. The midpoint rule was simply taking this f of x, substituting it into the integral, and then integrating. We got the midpoint rule here with the I sub h equals f times h times f of h over 2, the value of f at the midpoint of the interval, plus error terms proportional to h cubed and h to the fifth. For the trapezoidal rule now, let's take our f of x Taylor series expansion and look at the value of this Taylor series at x equals 0. So we have f of 0 is equal to f of h over 2 minus h over 2 times f prime of h over 2 plus h over 2 squared over 2, which is h over 8, or h squared over 8, times f double prime of h over 2, plus or minus, sorry, this is alternating signs, so the next one is a minus, and then we have an h cubed, and then we have 2 cubed, which is 2, 4, 8 times 6, so 48 of f triple prime of h over 2. And then the last term will be a plus, so plus h to the fourth. And then we have 2 to the fourth times 24, which works out to 384, so over 384 times the fourth derivative, okay, and so on. That's f of 0. If we look at the other point on the interval, that would be f of h. Everything's exactly the same, except that instead of the minus signs, we have plus signs. So we have the same here, but then it's a plus here, and then another plus. So all the minus signs turn into a plus sign. So what we can do then is to add them, and the terms that are minus here will cancel. The terms that will plus will double. So we can look at h over 2 times f of 0 plus f of h. And what do we get left? So all the minus signs cancel, all the plus signs add, and we divide by 2 and multiply by h. So the first term will be h times f of h over 2. The next term will be this one, so plus h cubed over 8 times f double prime of h over 2. And the minus sign will cancel. And the last one will be this one, plus h to the fifth, we multiplied by h, divided by 384 times f fourth of h over 2. Okay, and then we drop all the higher order terms. This is the trapezoidal rule. So this h of f of h over 2 is just this piece, the leading order term in the midpoint rule. So we can replace h times f of h over 2 by I sub h minus h cubed over 24 f double prime minus h to the fifth over 1920 f fourth prime. Okay? And then rewriting this expression, we can solve for IH. Okay? So we replace this one by this one. We plug in IH minus these things, and then we solve for IH. And then the final result, which I'll put in this color here, is that our elementary formula for the trapezoidal rule will be h over 2 times f of 0 plus f of h, right? The average of the value of f at the two endpoints of the interval. And then you add all the error terms, you get a minus h cubed over 12 f double prime of h over 2. And the last term will be minus h to the fifth over 480, the fourth derivative of f at h over 2. And those are all the terms that I'll need to keep. Okay? So this is our elementary integration formula. So let me quickly review the derivation. We're looking to find the integral from 0 to h, f of x dx. We have a Taylor series for f, which we use to derive the midpoint rule. So we can make use of the midpoint rule in deriving the trapezoidal rule. To derive the trapezoidal rule, we can look at this Taylor series at f of 0 and at f of h. All the terms are the same, except at f of 0, we have alternating signs. At f of h, all the signs are positive. We can add them, multiply by h, and divide by 2. Then the leading order term will be h times f of h over 2, which is exactly the midpoint rule. And then we have the two error terms. Then we can use the midpoint rule to substitute in the integral, I sub h, and the error terms. Solve for I sub h, and we end up with the trapezoidal rule. So I sub h is h over 2, f of 0 plus f of h. And then we have a handle on the two error terms, which we will need in the next video when we derive Simpson's rule. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.